Friday lunchtime video, guys. This is Rusty 78609, and let's touch on a point here. You know, I always say that I try to make my life an adventure, and I do. And I do a lot of crazy stuff that I know y'all think is really weird, you know, for a guy my age. But, you know, I am a weird guy for my age. But having said that, yeah, this thing I'm into with the runaway cool camp thing, yeah, it's moving along nicely. I still like the concept, and, you know, but... You know, why do I do stuff like this? Guys, it takes my mind off the mundane routine of life, okay? Because, you know, just getting up in the morning and doing three meals a day and taking going back to sleep, that's not really exciting, is it? And so, yeah, that's why I do these things. And, yeah, this will be a nice little fun thing to do to get the little small camper and basically pulling a bed down the highway. And I'm looking at another option because I may have to get another vehicle. I mentioned that in comment call this morning. And if I do have to get another vehicle, there's a slim chance. In fact, somebody left a email that I read this morning that kind of got my thinking in a, not a new direction, but kind of a adding to the direction I'm headed. And, you know, they make like Nissan minivans and Ford minivans and Chevy minivans, you know, the little ones, the little cargo vans. And they're pretty economical, you know, 25 miles a gallon plus, but they got all that room in the back, you know, to put stuff. Now, one question would be, well, you know, why don't you just get the minivan and not get the camper? There's a good point there, you know, I mean, but the downside of it is you'd have to add some kind of cooling inside of that thing other than just the dash AC of the van. And if you combine the two, I remember I did a video of a guy at it was a state park in New Mexico, something lake. I'll think of it maybe, and he had a Wii Roll, which is very small, and he also had a little minivan, and he had his little minivan set up like kind of an office where he could do his stuff. And yeah, it was really neat, man. He was totally off grid when he wanted to be, and when he could plug in and stuff. So thinking along those lines, but again, I'm not gonna, he's living in it. He's been living in it for like 4 years, you know, traveling around at state parks, national parks, boondocking and stuff. But I'm not planning on doing that, I don't think. But, you know, if it turns out that way, I'll do it. You know, if I really get into this, hell, this place here could go up for sale like that. It doesn't mean a damn thing to me. I don't buy boat anchors, you know what I mean? I buy sailboats, you know what I mean? So there's my thinking right there, is that I'm going to check on prices of those minivans. I think you probably get one, I don't know, $20,000, $25,000. I don't know how much they are. I'm just guessing. But, yeah, that's not bad, because anything I get above the Spark that tows 2,000 pounds or in that range, which is basically the minimum, is in that price range. You know, so I thought, well, wait a minute. Why would I want to get like an SUV or a Honda HRV or whatever else they make, when I could just get a little minivan from Chevrolet, Ford, or Nissan? And it's all I need. You know, in fact, it would come in very handy for hauling stuff for the house and, you know, just hauling stuff when you need to, you know, because the little car I have, we manage, but, you know, if I needed to go get a sheet of plywood, which I don't, I mean, I'm just, you know, whenever you think you want something, you create a need, you know what I mean? You create a reason to buy it. You know, you sell yourself. But yeah, what it is, I'm just making life an adventure, and I may pursue that. So if any of you guys know anything about these little minivans and stuff, and I'm not going to buy used unless it was just super good deal, but I'll probably just buy new because it comes with a new warranty and all that stuff. And they are classified as a commercial vehicle, so your insurance rates are a little higher. And if you finance them, then your insurance rates are a little higher too, because it's a commercial vehicle. Now, what that has to do with anything, I do not know, but that's the way it is. So, just giving you a little update there, and we'll talk more about it at Beer 30 around 5 o'clock this afternoon. We'll have a beer and kind of chill out and get ready for the weekend. But, yeah, I just wanted to give you a heads up, guys. The adventure continues, and I'm modifying the adventure now. You know, I can put a Type 1 or Class 1 hitch on the Spark, but again, it says clearly in the owner's manual, you know, not designed for towing or something like that, and so there's a reason for that, and so I probably will end up getting something else, but if the something else, instead of being like a little SUV or something, The price of those is the same as these little minivans. So that's kind of where I am on the deal. But anyway, guys, enjoy your Friday afternoon and look forward to seeing you at Beer 30. Adios, amigos. Carry on. Bye-bye. Buy anything you want. Use the Amazon link if you choose to. Just click on it. Go to Amazon. Buy whatever you want. Drink plenty of water. Stretch, walk, and stand guard at the door of your life. And enjoy the adventure of just being here, man. Anyway, adios, amigos. Bye-bye. Always thinking, man. Always thinking.